This Advent, we have been mindful of the many graces we are given by God each day, all while preparing our hearts to respond to those graces in a positive way. We are called to be instruments of peace in the world today. Mary and Joseph were the ultimate example of what it means to show courage in the face of fear in order to bring Christ to others. Let us reflect on their journey and how it can inspire us to holiness. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, said, "Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with the man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Now this is how the birth of Jesus came about. When his mother, Mary, was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with a child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly, such as was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said,
"Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet,
"Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us."
When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took his wife into his home.
Yeah.
certainly relate to what it feels like to be afraid and to doubt. We are sometimes too busy to even notice the presence of Christ in our day-to-day lives. We need to remember to take the time to search for and believe in Christ's loving presence. We can learn from the examples of Mary, Joseph, and the simple shepherds who came to seek Christ because of their humble hearts.
While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim you to good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Messiah and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger."
And suddenly, there is a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let us go then to Bethlehem to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us."
So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them.
Oh.
Let us remember, especially in the hustle and bustle of these days, to be still, to quiet ourselves, and listen to Christ in our lives. He wants us to take time to seek the truth, grace, and love that He so often shares with us. We can find Him in the lives of those we meet. We can find Him at Holy Mass. We can take time to listen in His true presence at adoration and offer Him the gift of our life well lived. Let us adore Him as the Magi did so very long ago.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from them east arrived in Jerusalem, saying,
"Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw His star at its rising and have come to do Him homage."
When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet,
'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'"
Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said,
"Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that I too may go and do him homage."